Welcome to the first episode of a new series where I debunk bad biology. All episodes are response videos explaining the fake science and then setting it right with facts. Yeah! There's a lot of it out there, so let's begin. Today's episode will be debunking MinuteEarth's recent viral video, Why It Sucks to Be a Male Hyena. If you haven't seen it, check out the link in the description below. The video was controversial. There was a lot of pain in the comments. People thought this unjust hyena hierarchy was because of feminism. It's not surprising that people thought this, because MinuteEarth made a bad video full of fake science. Before I explain why it sucks to believe MinuteEarth's video, let me give a quick recap. MinuteEarth tell us that spotted hyenas live in a female-dominated hierarchy. They claim this cruel, rigid social structure leads to the oppression and suffering of male hyenas. Supposedly, poor males like Scarface are forced out of clans in search of mates, where they are abused and forced into the lowest possible rank. Abuse and deprivation is unavoidable. The poor males are imprisoned in their low position. Apparently, the only way for them to escape and move up the hierarchy is for older males to die or for new males to arrive in the clan. And why do males suffer? MinuteEarth claim that the massive size and extreme aggression of females allow them to control the clan by overpowering and excluding all males. And females are seen to live a life of luxury. They have higher social privilege by controlling baby making, they eat the tastiest cuts of meat, and they sleep in the best, most softest savanna spots. Essentially, MinuteEarth present a rigid gender hierarchy where males are forced to queue in the lower ranks whilst females and their cubs are born into power and privilege. Now that you're up to date, let me debunk a lot of MinuteEarth's bad science. Adult males are not forced out of their birth glands and may remain if there are available mates. Males that remain can retain the rank they are born into. So adult males can occupy higher ranks than females. There's not a strict divide based on gender as shown in the MinuteEarth video. The risk of inbreeding means that many male hyenas leave their clans to find available mates. In these instances, males join the new clan in the lowest rank. This is not because they are male. It's because hierarchy is organized by friendship and family ties. Spotted hyenas are highly social mammals, and the depth and variety of an individual's social connections is what supports their social rank. Males fill the lowest ranks when they join the new clan, because they are outsiders, and they have to build up all their relationships from scratch. Spotted hyenas are born into their rank and do not compete over it, which makes hyena hierarchy extremely rigid. Top-ranking individuals are members of top-ranking bloodlines that stretch back over generations and generations. It's virtually impossible for any hyena to improve its rank without waiting in the queue. This means that a hyena's rank and privilege are tightly linked to its bloodline, rather than linked to its gender. Unlike many males, mother hyenas remain in their clans and have wider and closer relationships with their family. This extensive support and the rigidity of hyena hierarchy means that the very highest position is exclusive to the most successful mother from the most high-ranking bloodline. So whilst MinuteEarth is wrong about hyena society being absolutely divided by gender, it might not be wrong that hyena society is matriarchal. You might be thinking, how can hyena society be a matriarchy when there's no strict gender divide? Well, there are several definitions of matriarchy. To find out if hyenas do live in a matriarchy, we need to be clear what a matriarchy is. Matriarchy can be defined as a social system in which females hold the primary power positions and roles of political leadership, social privilege, and control of resources at the specific exclusion of males. When MinuteEarth used female-dominated society, they are using it in the same way as matriarchy is defined here. However, matriarchy is frequently confused with female-centric social systems. In order to be clear which ones apply to spotted hyena society, let's highlight the options. Matrilineality is a system in which offspring are defined as part of their mother's lineage. Matrilineal inheritance is when properties are passed down from the mother rather than the father. Matrilocality is the tendency for males to leave their birth group and reside in or mate with females of a different group. Matrifocality is a family structure where mothers head families and fathers are less present in the raising of offspring. So with this under our belt, let's go through each point that MinuteEarth uses to make us think that spotted hyena society is a matriarchy. The first reason that MinuteEarth interprets hyena society as a matriarchy is because males are seen to be excluded from resources. Is this true? Males are not excluded from resources, but many give up their rank privileges in order to increase their access to potential mates. Recall how hierarchy is based on a hyena's inherited social support and kinship connections. Many male hyenas have poorer access to resources because they experience a loss of rank and social support when leaving their birth clan. However, if the birth clan contains available mates, males may choose to remain. These remaining adult males may have better access to resources than other resident females, depending on their inherited rank. This is a factor in male hyenas' decision making on whether to leave, as they weigh up the potential opportunities of leaving against their inherited privileges. In fact, males who suffer illness or injury after leaving the clan in search of mates have been observed to return, where they are accepted back into their birth rank. You might be thinking, why do males have to leave? Why not the females? To answer this, let's look at the conditions surrounding reproduction and parenting. Part of the reason why hyena society is largely matrilocal, why males rather than females leave to search for mates, is because neither gender monopolizes reproduction. Hyena reproduction is unique. Both male and female hyenas have a penis. In order to be penetrated, females must invert their penis. This process takes time, and females risk injury with each mating attempt. Because of this, sex between hyenas is highly ritualized and reciprocal. Males typically initiate courtship by tentatively approaching and bowing towards females. When a female accepts the proposition, she will bow her head to the ground. She will then invert her penis and alter her stance to allow the male to mount. Highly ritualized courtship and the fact that both sexes take multiple partners show how reproduction cannot be described as matriarchal according to the previous definition. The males are not excluded from choice of partner or monopolized for their role in reproduction. Having multiple sexual partners is an important tactic to protect the young from infanticide, but makes it difficult for hyenas to identify paternal relationships. This helps explain why hyena society is organized by maternal bloodlines. Without monopolizing reproduction, male hyenas cannot determine the sexual hierarchy. The impact of sexual behavior on parenting style is the second reason why the males migrate instead of females, which has knock-on effects for the social structure. Let me explain. Spotted hyena society is matrifocal, as males take no part in parental activities. Males do not take part not only because of hyena sexual behaviour, but also because of a second tactic to protect against infanticide. A mother protects her cubs by isolating them in a private den for around a month. Cubs are then taken to a larger communal den, which is shared with other cubs and their mothers. It is within these early stages of life that hyenas are socialised, learning the unique clan customs and position in the hierarchy. Matrilineality further explains why females cannot migrate for sexual partners. If a mother left her birth clan, she would sacrifice the rank available to her offspring, as opposed to a male who can lose his rank and yet still father high-ranking offspring. So the relationship between the mother and her cubs is very important for the success of her bloodline. Consequently, hyena society is matrilocal because males are more able to leave their birth clan. In order to ensure the success of the species and the clan, particular parenting strategies have evolved to avoid inbreeding and infanticide. These strategies are vital to hyenas and have proven very successful, as hyenas are the widest spread land carnivore in Africa. You might be thinking, okay, so the males shouldn't take father roles, but why should they not lead the clans in hunting, protecting territory, and in general hyena politics? To understand this, we need to know the context in which hyenas live. Hyenas live in extreme conditions with fluctuating resources. Consequently, clans are highly competitive over food and territory. This has created untrusting and wary relationships between hyena clans. The movement of hyenas is heavily policed, with daily patrols being conducted and newcomers enduring hazing and exclusion. Although female hyenas have been observed forcing other females out of the clan, resident males are not forced out by female aggression. In fact, male hyenas take a larger role than females in controlling the membership of other males. The hazing of outsiders is more likely to be carried out by clan males rather than resident females. Adult hyenas of both sexes take part in defending their friendships, family, and resources. On this basis, the injustice outlined by MinuteEarth of physically fit and socially capable male hyenas being excluded from decision making is untrue. Finally, the MinuteEarth video explains that males are violently made submissive because the females are bigger and meaner. It implies that they live in a female-dominated society because they are physically dominated over. Is this true? Well, first off, we need to combat one of MinuteEarth's false statements. Dominance over males does not come about because of the females being bigger and meaner. Rank is not based on size or combat ability, but is matrilineally inherited. Consequently, aggression is not something that decides rank. The highest levels of aggression occur between females. So aggression may be a way of demonstrating, but not deciding rank. Additionally, aggression is a key part of the insider-outsider conflict. This best explains female-to-male aggression, as it is most likely to occur between resident females and migrant males. Instances of aggression also occur in the context of reproduction, as female hyenas protect their offspring from infanticide inflicted by migrating males. Female aggression is therefore used to protect the clan and the offspring. Male-to-female aggression also occurs, particularly during important moments in reproduction. For instance, migrant males group together to attack lone females around the time of conception. This has been speculated as a tactic to influence mate choice. Consequently, aggression plays a complex role in hyena society that cannot conclusively be determined as instances of gendered dominance. And what is conclusive is that MinuteEarth's simplified account of gendered dominance is not true, and certainly not the basis of hyena society as a matriarchy. So what does this all mean? Is hyena society matriarchal? Male hyenas are not excluded from resources, reproduction, or decision making. Neither are they victims of gendered dominance. The way that MinuteEarth explains hyena matriarchy is fake science. It is not the inverse of patriarchy. Hyena society is matriarchal insofar as it is matrilineal, matrifocal, and often matrilocal. Whether these systems make it suck to be a male hyena is another question. Join us next time to find out the answer.